إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when a year ends and a new one begins, a Muslim, a believer, must stop and assess his journey back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today is the second day of Shahrullah al-Muharram, and it is the second day of the new Hijri year, the year 1434 after Hijrah. And this also to be done when so and so birthdays are around, and so Gregorian New Year is around, if you want. This is what a Muslim should do. لأنه بانقضاء هذا العام اقتربت إلى الوصول. By the fact that this year is over, you're basically 1 year closer to Allah, to your destination. الإمام علي بن أبي طالب, سيدنا علي أمير المؤمنين رضي الله عنه, expressed this in a very beautiful, eloquent way, and he said, ألا إن الدنيا قد ارتحلت مدبرة وألا إن الآخرة قد ارتحلت مقبلة. Indeed, this world is going away, is coming to an end. And every year, every month, every day, every hour brings you nearer to your end. And indeed, your akhirah already is traveling towards you. So when you're traveling, you're leaving the dunya behind and you're approaching al-akhirah. That is what he needed to say. That is what he meant to say. Fudayl ibn Iyad, one of our righteous predecessors, he met a man. فسأله, He asked him this question, "Kam umruk?" How old are you? He said, "Sittuna sana," or "Sittuna ama," 60 years. He said to him, "Mundu sittina aman wa anta musafirun ila rabbik wa qad awshakta ala al-wusul." Since 60 years you've been traveling to Allah and you're about to arrive. رجل بكى ما العمل يا أبا علي What should I do يا أبا علي فقال له He said to him أحسن فيما بقي من عمرك يغفر لك الله ما مضى Strive Do your best To do better With what is left of your life Allah will forgive your past. Brothers and sisters in Islam, having a long life and restricted yani is not praiseworthy. Living a lot of years just like that is not good and restricted. Here is the hadith which explains that. Abdullah ibn Bisr رضي الله عنه والحديث في سنن الترمذي وقال عنه صحيح سئل النبي the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked about يا رسول الله من خير الناس who are the best of people صلى الله عليه وسلم says من طال عمره وحسن عمله The one who lives long life, but with one condition. He does act righteously. وسئل And he was asked, صلى الله عليه وسلم, عن شر الناس, the worst of people. قال, صلى الله عليه وسلم, من طال عمره وساء عمله. The one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a long life. But he's always acting evil. That is why, ya ikhwa, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make that dua. Kama inda Muslim min hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Waj'alil hayata زيادة لي في كل خير. Oh Allah, if you make me live, make it an increase for me of goodness, a provision. واجعل الموت راحة لي من كل شر. And if I am not to gain goodness, good things, good deeds in my life to come, Then give me a break with death. ودعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما عند النسائي في السنن بسند صحيح من حديث عمار بن ياسر رضي الله عنه يقول عمار says الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم always used to make this دعاء اللهم بعلمك الغيب وبقدرتك على الخلق أحيني ما علمت الحياة خيرا لي وتوفني إذا علمت الوفاة شرا لي خيرا لي Oh Allah I call upon you by your knowledge of the unseen تستطيع أن تتوسل لله بأسمائه وصفاته And your ability over your creation to make me live, if life is good for me, take me if death is good for me. Ya ikhwa, having a long life becomes a hujjah against you. Yani, when you live a lot of years, if Allah gives you a lot of years, it becomes an evidence against you. The disbelievers in the hellfire, they would cry loud. وَهُمْ يَصْطَرِخُونَ فِيهَا رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا نَعْمَلْ غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلْ نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلْ. O Allah, take us of the hellfire, bring us back to life so we can do much better than what we used to do. Look how Allah answers them. أَوَلَمْ نُعَمِّرْكُمْ. Haven't we given you the chance in this world? مَا يَتَذَكَّرُ فِيهِ مَنْ تَذَكَّرُ وَجَاءَكُمُ النَّذِيرُ. And we sent you warners. Ibn Abbas, Ya Ikhwa, and Qatada, and others, they said, warners, gray hair, shape. Somebody lives until he see gray hair in his body. Shape hada, the gray hair is a sign that you're hitting the deep end here. Qalu shape. Another explanation of al-nadhir, the death of beloved ones around you. Here you are, you're living, you're growing old, and al-ahibba, family members, beloved ones, they fall down one after another. Every day you're taking someone to the grave, to the cemetery. Imam al-Bukhari, لما جاءه خبر موت شيخه الإمام الدارمي, he said this, إن عشت تفجع بالأحبة كلهم وذهاب نفسك لا أب لك أفجع. If you live long life, you suffer. How? All your beloved ones, family members are dying, and you grieve over and over and over again. The third meaning of al-Nadhir, قال ابن عباس الستون سنة, that you live until you reach the age 60. Why, ya ikhwa, the age 60 in particular? لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما عند الترمذي يقول, he says, أعمار أمتي بين الستين والسبعين. The overwhelming majority of my followers will get to live between 60 and 70. وقليل منهم من يجاوز ذلك. Some will cross. Some will live longer. And some, of course, will die before. But the overwhelming, the average Muslim, 60. That is why Ibn Abbas explained the Nadir to be 60. You know, when you hit 60, that means any time now. وَيُفَسِّرُ هَذَا قَوْلُ النَّبِيِّ حَدِيثَ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ كَمَا عِنْدَ الْبُخَارِي فِي كِتَابِ الرِّقَاقِ قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أعذر الله إلى امرئ أطال عمره حتى بلغ الستين سنة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given enough excuses to a man or a woman whom he prolonged his life to live until the age of 60. I guess the point that I'm trying to make is, receiving a new year or seeing off a year that passed of your life is not a place for you to throw a party. Is not a place for you to even ask Sheikh is celebrating birthdays allowed in Islam or not? And I receive these questions, we receive these questions over and over and over again. And you know who ask it? Our youth, our children. Of course it is not. And I'm not here to nag about that. But if you really reason, if you really reflect upon what I just said, you should not even be asking that question. What are you celebrating? Losing 1 year of your capital, of your asset. Your asset, your capital is time. Is time. The years that you have. You're supposed to utilize these years to inherit another everlasting life. The fact that you lost a year of that capital, you're celebrating it. But here is an analogy. When you lose $1 million, do you throw a party? Do you? You lost a year. ولذلك our righteous breed says الإنسان ساعات. الإنسان is sets of hours, some hours. إذا مضى ساعة بقي بعض الساعة. When an hour goes away, finishes, you still have some hours left over. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when a year passes or ends and another one comes, this is a time, like I said at the very beginning of my khutbah, to reassess the journey. How is it going? This is the time to do something called Muhasabah nafs, calling yourself to account. What did I do with my past? And what I'm about to do with my coming years? And this is something that cannot happen in the midst of a birthday party. No, this is something that you have. That is why another word for this is soul searching. Soul searching. Critiquing yourself. You don't do this when happy birthday to you. You don't do this when you have some Muslims have liquors around, have mixing around. You don't do that. This is something that is very, very personal. Inshallah, in the moments to come, I would like to explain the term Muhasabah nafs. And I'm coming really hesitant to even bring this up because some of these concepts are extremely difficult to explain, especially in another language. But I will do my best, hoping that my brothers will do that, will call themselves to account. First of all, Muhasabah nafs. Muhasabah means calling to account, reckoning. In nafs is in nafs. First of all, is it something that we should do? And what is the evidence? Let's establish that first. The evidence in Surah Al-Hashr. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَالْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. O ye who believe, have taqwa, be conscious of Allah, and let every soul look into what they have sent for tomorrow. Tomorrow is al-akhirah. Have you sent anything? سأل أحد الأمراء, one of our predecessors, he said to him, لماذا نحب الدنيا ونبغض الآخرة? Why are we so in love with the dunya and الآخرة, death? Said, لأنكم عمرتم دنياكم وخربتم أخراكم فالإنسان جبل على حب ما عمر. Because everything that you do is for the dunya, for this world. But al-akhirah, you have not sent anything there. That is why you're not looking forward to it. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّيًا. MashaAllah, there are people who do this. Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, let every soul look into what you have sent tomorrow. يقول ابن كثير, look what ابن كثير said, صاحب التفسير. He said what? You better look into what you have sent for tomorrow. Will it save your nafs or not? Now whatever you do today in this dunya, it will save your nafs from the hellfire and place it in Jannah, or vice versa. That is why look and check and see what you have sent for tomorrow. وفي مسند أحمد روية عن عمر بن الخطاب بسند صحيح رضي الله عنه. عمر says, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا وزنوا أعمالكم قبل أن توزن عليكم وتهيأوا ليوم العرض يوم لا يخفى على الله منكم خافية. Call yourselves to account before you are called to account. You will be called. وقفوهم إنهم مسؤولون. You better call yourself to account before you're called to account. And place what you have done in the scale. And see if it will have any way or not, any weight or not. Brothers and sisters in Islam, muhasabatu nafs, two words. In nafs. Do you know anything about your nafs? Your soul? Have you ever went in a quest to study about your nafs? Hear this. النفس في أصل خلقتها ظلومة جهولة. The nafs that you have, if you leave it the way you received it, it will be ignorant and it will be unfair and unjust. هو أصل النفس الظلم والجهل إلا إذا جاءها نور الوحي. ظلم and جهل. Those two attributes, by the way, are with the nafs when it was delivered to you. دليلي, my evidence, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَ أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَ مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. We presented the amana to the mountains, to the heavens, to the earth. They said no. الْأَمَانَةَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You choose to submit to Allah willingly. They said no. Fashion us, Ya Rab, unwillingly in a state of submission to you. But mankind said, I will do this, Ya Rab. Give me the freedom of choice. Why? إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا. He was unjust, unfair, جَهُولًا. unaware of the consequences. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken you out of the wombs of your mothers, do not know anything. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ, then He given you hearings. وَالْأَبْصَارَ, and sights, so you can learn. The point that I'm trying to make, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the nafs that you have, if you do not call it to account, it will get you to commit injustice. If you do not tell it to stop, it will always take you to destruction. Isma, إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. النَّفْس is inclined to evil. Three words, two tools of affirming. إِنَّ وَلَأَمَّارَةٌ. إِنَّ حرف توكيد, لَأَمَّارَةٌ حرف توكيد. هذا الشاعر يقول يا إخوة, listen what he says, والظلم من شيم النفوس فإن ترى ذا عفة فلعلة لا يظلم. By default your nafs wants to commit injustice. If you see somebody who doesn't, he has a reason. That reason could be taqwa, the fear of Allah, taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you want to commit injustice against somebody else. Astaghfirullah. No, I'm not going to do this because I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nurul wahy. Wahy. The knowledge. The knowledge tells you this is haram. That is why I'm telling you, if you leave your nafs the way it is, the way it is without knowledge, it will take you to ruin, to destruction. That is why you need the nafs to learn what is lawful and what is not lawful. And based on that, you can tell your nafs, you done haram. This is good. This is bad. Other people stay away from injustice because fear of law. Or because of hypocrisy, they just want some benefit. But in general, brothers and sisters in Islam, your nafs, if you leave it the way it was fashioned, the way it was delivered to you, without teaching it the knowledge of the religion, the divine, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it will never know what is good for it and what is bad for it. And it will take you to ruin. Brothers and sisters in Islam, some of the people was walking in the desert. Just to make sure that you understand this meaning. And he saw a sanctuary. And he called upon the person inside it. And here is what he said. أَيُّهَا الْعَابِدِ أيها الناسك, O worshipper, O righteous person, answer me. He would not answer him. Then he kept calling upon him using other names over and over. So the man came out of his sanctuary and he said to him, what do you want? So the person said, I've been calling you. Said, you have not been calling you with my name. You called me a worshipper. You called me a righteous person. I'm not. أَنَا كَلْبٌ عَقُورٌ. My nafs is a crazy dog. And I'm jailing it inside that sanctuary in order not to attack other people. This is how far your nafs can be. And that is why you need to call it to account. You need to reassess what your nafs is doing. الكيس الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت. The smart believer is the one who calls himself to account and ask his nafs, why did you do this? But the other person, the loser, is the one who goes with his nafs. Let's have this. Let's do this. And then in the day of resurrection, ruin and hellfire. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أخرج ابن أبو الدنيا في كتابه محاسبة النفس عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. Anas says, I was walking with Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه during the time when he was Amir al-Mu'mineen. He said to him, can you please hold on? I'll be right back. And Umar went to Ha'it, Hadiqa, a garden, and he started talking to himself. بخن بخن يا ابن الخطاب أمير المؤمنين والله يا عمر إن لم تتق الله لا يحرقنك في نار جهنم. بخن بخن يا ابن الخطاب. أو يا عمر أمير المؤمنين, ها يور أمير المؤمنين ناو, ها باي الله يا عمر, if you do not fear Allah, if you do not do what is right, Allah will burn you in the hellfire. Muhasabah. Ibrahim al-Taymi لا يعرفه كثير من المسلمين ولكن الله يعرفه. He said, I took my nafs and I had it enjoy the delight of Jannah. This is Jannah. In Jannah, there is food. فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. In Jannah, what an eye never seen, what an ear never heard, and whatever you desire, you will have it. And then I took my nafs to hell, and I told her, dwell in hell for a while, burn. And then I ask my nafs, which one you want? She said, I want, the nafs said, the second one. I want Jannah. I said, work then. Start working then for it. Work. Brothers and sisters in Islam, he dug a grave beneath his bed. He dug a grave. This is how much muhasabah they used to make. He had a grave in his bedroom, under his bed. And every now and then, he would go inside it. And how would you feel? Muhammad ibn Wasi', one day he placed his hand, his finger on the fire. What do you think? Brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to do this. A Muslim must be engaged in that over and over again. Especially in these occasions, receiving a Hijri year, a new year, or when you have your birthday, that is a new year in your life. You should call yourself to account. and ask yourself the following questions. How much knowledge you have of the religion? How much knowledge you have of Islam? Listen, you may be elite in the society. You may have a PhD in one of these fields, but I'm talking about the knowledge of who Allah is and how you worship Allah. العلم يا إخوة, the knowledge who Allah is. They tell you the knowledge is two branches. من تعبد وكيف تعبده. Who is Allah? Who do you worship? توحيد. لا إله إلا الله. And how do you worship him? محمد رسول الله. What is going on with the pillars, my nafs? How come you're not praying five times, my nafs? What do you want? Why you're not doing it? Why when the first question you will be asked, my nafs, in the day of resurrection, is a salah? أول ما يسأل عنه العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة. The first question that a Muslim will be asked in the day of resurrection is a salah. That is not the Christ. That is not the Christ. That is not the bad thing. Here it is. فَإِن صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ سَائِرُ الْعَمَلِ. If the salah is valid, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your zakah, your sadaqah, enjoining good, forbidding evil, helping the community, all of this, as if the salah is the notarization for the rest of the deeds. Instead of throwing a party and having a birthday party, ask your nafs, how come you have not prayed five times? How come? Do you pray on time, my nafs? إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا, my nafs. Salah is to be observed in its time, my nafs. Why you're not praying on time, my nafs? Why do you plan the salah when it is the most important thing around your schedule? Meanwhile, you should plan your schedule around your salah. When you wake up in the morning, today at 12, I'm going to be in that place. That is dhuhr time. How I'm going to pray dhuhr? What is the closest masjid? Where? I need to make wudu. Where I'm going to go to make wudu? If I have an issue with touching the ground with my forehead, I'll take a prayer rug with me. Plan the salah. No. A Muslim now? Huh? Well, I'm busy. I'm driving. Some of them at work. He shies away. A lot of Muslims. They shy away at work. You know why? Because he doesn't want to upset his boss. His boss, when he sees him praying, he's going to find out that he's a Muslim. My boss, I'm going to please you at the expense of Allah. من أرضى الناس بسخط الله أسخط الله عليه الناس. That boss will fire you one day, based on that hadith. If you make somebody happy at the expense of Allah, Allah will turn that person against you. He will fire you. فالصلاه, my nafs, five times. How are you praying, my nafs? How are you praying? The messenger who was sent to you, my nafs, to purify you, said, صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي, my nafs. Pray like you seen me pray. When you pray, my nafs, do you like, you just pray like your father, your ancestor? Is that what you do, my nafs? Is that the right thing to do? You're supposed to pray like the Prophet, like the Messenger prayed. And on and on. Sisters, my nafs, the hijab is not an option, my nafs, sisters, yani. The hijab is not an option. It's a command in the Quran, in the Sunnah. The hijab is not a religious symbol. It's not like the cross, it's not like the hamaka. No, the hijab is a requirement for a Muslim. Why my nafs? Why? Because you want to look beauty? You want to look beautiful to the people? You want to show your qualities to the people, my nafs? Huh? What about the hellfire, my nafs? صنفان من أهل النار لم أرهما. The Prophet says, two kinds of people, I saw them in fire, but I have not seen them in this world yet. نساء كاسيات عاريات مائلات مميلات. Women who are dressed, but they are not dressed. They walk around. You see like these models, how they walk. مائلات مميلات. محاسبة يا أختي. Ya ukhti fillah, wallahi, I say this because I care. Wallahi, because I care. And Allah is my witness. Because I care, my sister. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أكثر أهل النار النساء. The majority of the dwellers of hell are women. Liya ukhti, why do you do this to your nafs? Why don't you call yourself to account right here in this area? What is going on with your children, brothers? What is going on? Are you keeping their fitrah? Allah given you children. He deprived others of children. Are you maintaining that fitrah? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كل مولود يولد على الفطرة فأبواه. What are you doing with your children? We are having issues here when your children come to the masjid. They're breaking everything. The other day my brother had a function with non-Muslims. We could not control the children running around. And those are non-Muslims. Then they would come play with the microphone. And why don't you take on the responsibility of bringing up your children? Teaching them the behaviors. ما هو هذا الأطفال نعمة لله ملك السماوات والأرض يخلق ما يشاء يهب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور يهب هبة من الله هبة gift from Allah. What are you doing with it? Are they learning their deen, their religion? Are you teaching them how to pray? And on, and I can go on here and I call my... That is what you need to do. When you see a year goes by from your life and a year comes. Not to throw a party and disobey already. La. This is what you should do. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Ummah needs to do this to help the Muslims. Our brothers are killed in Gaza. Our brothers are killed in Sham. Our brothers are killed in Burma. يُوشِكُ أَن تَدَاعَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأُمَمُ كَمَا تَدَاعَ الْأَكَلَةُ إِلَى قَصَعَتِهَا أو من قلة نحن يومئذ يا رسول الله لا كثير 1.56 now 6 billion Muslims كثير. It's like a foam of a sea. Why يا رسول الله لينزعن الله من قلوب أعدائكم مخافتكم ولا يقذفن في قلوبكم الوهن. Allah will extract from the chests of your enemies your fear, and He will cast into your hearts الوهن, fear, weakness. قالوا وما الوهن يا رسول الله. What causes that weakness in the heart, O Messenger of Allah? حب الدنيا. حب الدنيا. Because you never called yourself to account. وكراهية الموت. And dislike in death. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I close by this, and I'm sorry I prolonged this, but in 2 minutes. Subhanallah, our righteous predecessors, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Umar and his council, Uthman and Ali radiallahu anil jami'a, chose one event to mark that lunar calendar. That event is called the Hijrah, the migration. You see, when you call yourself to account, you will find out that you have to do Hijrah. But not from a place to another. لا. والمهاجر ما هو الهجرة الأولى. The Hijrah from Mecca to Medina is over. لا هجرة بعد الفتح. هكذا قال. No Hijrah after فتح. After فتح مكة. طيب. There is one type of Hijrah still left. والمهاجر من يهجر ما نهى الله عنه. The immigrant now is the one who leaves the haram and the vicinity of the haram and travels to the halal. What will save him? You see, when you call yourself to account, then this is what you need to do. You start traveling. Even if you figure out that you have done so much, a man killed 100 souls, but he did hijrah, and he ended up in Jannah. But start here. Intend. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا, إسرافنا في أمرنا, ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في غزة وفي بلاد الشام وفي بلاد بورما يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لهم عونا ويدا ونصيرا على من عاداهم. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, أرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.
الله أكبر, الله أكبر, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة, حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة, قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا, استووا, استقيموا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين, الرحمن الرحيم, مالك يوم الدين, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون